welcome. You're with IndiaPostLive.com, India's first live conversation web television. This is your platform where we discuss everything that is happening on social media. And you can participate in our discussions and our conversations by just clicking on a participation button. You can also send us your tweets at hashtag IndiaPostLive and @IndiaPostLive. You can send us your video comments, your audio comments and your posts at IndiaPostLive.com. So we are here with a fresh edition, today's edition of Trend Tonic, the show where we give you an update of whatever is trending on social media, especially Twitter and Facebook today. So let's start. The first story, of course, you're all aware that former Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh has been summoned by a special court in connection with the coal scam, or rather the coal block allocation case involving Hindalco that is owned by Kumar Mangalam Birla. So that hashtag is trending, coal scam, and also PM Manmohan Singh. That is trending. Along with Dr. Singh's, the special judge Bharat Parashar, he has also summoned industrialist Kumar Mangalam Birla, former coal secretary PC Parakh, and two other officials of Hindalco. The accused have been, there is an alleged charge of criminal conspiracy, criminal breach of trust under various sections of the Prevention of Corruption Act. So that is what definitely is our top trend on social media. A lot of political leaders have also reacted to what is happening today. A lot of people have come out in support of Dr. Singh, saying that he has basically been, he has got himself embroiled in this controversy without himself directly being at fault. So let's take a look at some of those tweets that are doing the rounds. The court had in fact directed the CBI to examine these officials as well as the former Prime Minister. Okay, Rangaraj says, silence is a true friend who never betrays, not the people who are silent. Former Prime Minister's silence has cost him and this nation a lot, says Chandan Sadhu. Now remember, this case relates to the allocation of the Talabira 2 coal block in Odisha to Hindalco in 2005. And that was when the then Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh also held the coal portfolio. Maximum punishment, if found guilty, is life imprisonment. I'd like to see him there, says Avdesh Kumar, somebody extremely angry. Manmohan Singh summoned, hope he will die before the final verdict. All right, a double-edged sword there, making fun of our judicial system. All development in India just because of this man, I salute. Rajiv Asthana. BJP says the former PM has to face CBI charges because of the wrongdoings of the Congress in the coal scam. That's All India Radio News. Okay, there is the coal scam and there is the LOL scam. All right, this is a parody account of Bilawal Bhutto. So that is doing the rounds. The Prime Minister himself has said he is upset by these allegations, but it is a part of life. Kapil Sibal has said that they will go all the way out to ensure that justice is done and ensure that someone who is not guilty is proven to be not guilty. Of course, a lot of other comments coming in from the BJP as well, saying that, we will have to ensure that the trial is smooth. Nalin Kohli has said it's a legal step. They can argue about it in the court. We cannot ignore the fact that it was a scam and that has been proven by the recent coal block auctions. Nalin Kohli, spokesperson of the BJP. It is unfortunate for the nation that a former PM has been summoned, and I'm happy that the law applies to everyone. The law will do its work now, Murli Manohar Joshi, BJP leader, that is what he has said. Mayawati has said that it's a matter for the judiciary. I think commenting would not be right and the decision would be based on facts. Mayawati playing it very safe there. Manmohan Singh is an honest person. It's not a big deal, says Sharad Yadav, JDU president. PC Parekh, former coal secretary, has said, it is inappropriate. I cannot make any comments. Nothing to be said. He has also, remember, I just told you, he has also been summoned. The UPS policies were the same as NDA's. The former PM and former government conducted itself with utmost transparency. Congress leader Manish Tiwari. Prakash Javadekar has said an economist PM has to face the court due to Congress scams. Manmohan Singh is paying for the mistakes of the Congress party. Kapil Sibal, like I just told you, that I don't think anyone believes that he can do something wrong, and we shall defend him with all our might. Of course, like I said, the former Prime Minister himself has said that he is upset, but it is a part of life. All right, moving on to our next story. Well, I did not really know about it till this morning. Are you all aware with the Adarsh Liberal meme? A very, very interesting meme that has come out. The Adarsh Liberal meme is, of course, a right-wing meme which shows a liberal boy attacking Hindu gods. It shows him eating beef and chicken while supporting PETA. That's People for Ethical Treatment of Animals. He also supports the Naxalites. He is a congenital liar. Now, this meme and related tweets have gone viral on the internet and on Twitter. Tweeples have completely gone. You also saw some tweets on the coal scam that mention hashtag Adarsh Liberal. Now, the most interesting thing is that in response to Adarsh Liberal, there is also something called the secular camp that released the Adarsh Bhakt meme. Now, the Adarsh Bhakt meme has been out to counter the Adarsh Liberal meme. And this particular meme, this boy, the Adarsh Bhakt, he worships Modi and Godse. He is prone to riots and patriotism. He eats beef secretly and hates homosexuals. Most interestingly, he happens to be a bright student. He tops Vedic maths and astrology. And every in the morning, his first drink is cow's urine or gomutra. Okay, so Adarsh Liberal is a huge trend on Twitter, and both Adarsh Liberal and Adarsh Bhakt, in fact, started off after, or rather, they were modeled on the same bad girl poster meme that had gone viral recently. Okay, Adarsh Liberal ki Adarshta is only applied to others and not to them. Please don't defame the noble souls. Okay. This speaks on behalf of the marginalized, does not believe in empowering with them. Because then what will the Adarsh Liberal do? Says Chetan Bhagat. Alright, so if you want to, because I was very curious when I saw this trending and I went and I saw that meme, it's really funny, and like I said, it is modeled on the bad girl poster meme, and this bad girl meme was created by four students of the Srishti Design School in Bangalore, and they wanted to expose the hypocrisy involved in the way girls and women are judged. So this Adarsh Liberal started off modeled on that. And of course, the secular people were quick to start off Adarsh Bhakt. They protest for tribal rights in star hotels. All right. The bull race is against human rights, but beef eating is within. A lot of people. Adarsh Liberal will eat tandoori chicken with a fork and knife. Okay, so basically people commenting on that meme. Adarsh Liberal, like I said, started by the right-wing groups, and secular groups have come out with Adarsh Bhakt. And finally, something that is not so political in nature, something that is in reality social media driven, people driven, tweeple driven. And this is something that is trending called Inspires me. Hashtag inspires me is what is trending. A random tweet like we've had others before. So people are telling us on Twitter on what inspires them. It could be a person, it could be a thing, it could be a philosophy. Whatever it is, hashtag inspires me is something that is once again trending on the social media. Take a look at some of the tweets. The best thing about my job is that my chair spins, okay? That's Paki Shukla, that's what inspires her. Somebody's naturalness and acceptability. Rashmi NP's effortlessness, naturalness is what inspires this person. Vasudha says, she commands yet she cares, shy yet she dares. Okay, she is a woman and I think she is talking about Vinita Rai. She inspires me, Vinita Rai inspires her. My mother inspires me, says Vinod Kumar. Stability of steely nerves, steady by healthy body at 79 and depth of ways of living by hard work and prayer. My mother Sharmila Tagore inspires me every day. A shining example that you can be a successful actor, wife and mother and be happy, says Soha Ali Khan. Kamlesh Barbu, Jasraj says, Kamlesh inspires Jasraj to serve selflessly and endlessly. Shri Shri Ravishankar, okay, that's the tweet. The transformation I see in timid women standing up for justice through spirituality. That inspires to bring the knowledge to rural areas. Okay, so quite a few philosophical tweets there on what inspires. Of course, the first one was very interesting, the fact that somebody has a spinning chair in office. All right, so if there is any other topic that you want to share with us that you think should be trending, why is it not trending? Let's make it a trend. Write into us at indiapostlive.com. Of course, you can comment on all these tweets that we just got you, all these topics that we got you, inspires me, and PM Manmohan Singh and the coal scam, and of course, liberal, Adarsh liberal. So these were the top trends in Indian social media that we have dug out for you and brought to you today. So that's your daily dose of Trend Tonic. Thank you so much for watching. We look forward to your comments and feedback. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.